ओम गणानां त्वा गणपतिं हवामहे कविं कवीनामुपमश्रवस्तमं ज्येष्ठराजं ब्रह्मणां ब्रह्मणस्पतान शृण्वन्नोतिभिः सीदसादनं श्रीमहागणाधिपतये नमः गुरुर्ब्रह्मा गुरुर्विष्णुः गुरुर्देवो महेश्वरः गुरुस्साक्षात् परं ब्रह्म तस्मै श्रीगुरवे नमः सदाशिवसमारम्भां शङ्कराचार्यमध्यमाम् अस्मदाचार्यपर्यन्तां वन्दे गुरुपरम्पराम् ओम् डियर् फ्रेण्ड्स् वी आर् इन् दि सेकेण्ड् चाप्टर् आफ् वेदान्त पञ्चदशि दि सेकेण्ड् चाप्टर्स् नेम् इस् महाभूत विवेक प्रकरणम् and in that sage Vidyaranya he is examining the reality or otherwise of the panchabhutas. He talked about the panchabhutas, that is the five elements, prithvi, tejo, vayu, akashah. Are they really real? Is there any reality in them? So that is the basic question. The basic question is about the nature of sat. In the very beginning, in the very first chapter, he talked about chit and the eternality of chit, and the not only the eternality, it is something which is all pervading, it is something which is ananta, so that he established. Now we are examining what is called sat. What is the nature of sat? And this, for this sat we have been seeing in the last shloka, we have seen idam ayam sadevasin namarupena swam ityaruner vachah. That is the description is about, or rather the elaboration is about sadeva somya idam agra asit. So that line from Chandogya Upanishad, sat eva somya idam agre asit, all this was sat alone in the beginning. In the beginning means before creation all this was sat. What does it mean? It can mean no longer it is sat. It can also mean, but it doesn't mean that. It is also sat even now. It is sat only. Sat in the sense, it is apparent, it is an appearance. It is actually, this is unreal. This is unreal in the sense, it is something whose reality cannot be established. So that is what we are going to see as mithya. So what exactly is the nature of this sat? So we have, in the last class we saw vrukshasya swagato bhedah patra pushpa phaladibhihi vrukshantara sajatiyo vijatiya shiladitah. The idea is that sat is something which cannot be negated at any point of time. Sat is something which always existed, that is beyond time. So that is what we, that is one thing. And sat is something in which there is no differentiation, either with respect to itself or with respect to something of the same class or with respect to something of a different class. So the differentiation with respect to oneself is what is called swagata bheda, swagata. He has given the example of a tree. In that example of a tree, the tree has got so many parts of its parts, and anything which is having parts is something which is delimited. Anything which consists of, which has so many parts, it is called avayavi. When something is avayavi, then it becomes finite, it becomes limited. Then you may visualize a huge thing, however big, however huge you may visualize, but still it is delimited because it is having some parts only. Then, so that is what he was saying, rukshasya swagato bheda. What exactly is the swagata bheda? What is sajatiya bheda? What is vijatiya bheda? He is saying, rukshasya swagato bheda patra pushpa phaladivihi. With respect to this fruit, flower, leaf, bark and all these branches, etc., etc., they are all the differentiation with respect to itself, swagata bheda. Vrukshantarat sajatiyah. You compare one mango tree with another litmus, some lemon tree. So this is also a tree, that is also a tree. So the sajatiya bheda. There is another called vijatiya bheda. A vruksha, you compare to some cup or something like that, or some stone or something else. So that is vijatiya bheda. So that also is sat, this also is sat. Suppose we say that also is sat and this also is sat, then again sat becomes totally delimited. So sat cannot be like that, because we are saying that Brahma is something which is sat. If we want to say sat, Brahma cannot be delimited. So that is the point. Then the next verse, next shloka is also saying, next shloka is saying about ekameva dvitiyam, it is elaborating. I'll read the shloka. Tatha sadvastuno bhedatrayam praptam nivariyate aikya avadharana dvaita pratishedhai stribhih kramat. Tatha sadvastuno bhedatrayam praptam nivariyate ఐక్య అవధారణ ద్వైత ప్రసిద్ధి ప్రతిషేధై త్రిభిః క్రమాత్ తథా లైక్ వైజ్ ఇన్ ద ఎర్లియర్ శ్లోక దట్ ఈస్ ఇన్ ద 20th శ్లోక హి సెడ్ స్వగత భేద వాట్ ఈస్ ద డిఫరెన్సియేషన్ ఆఫ్ స్వగత ఎట్సెట్రా సజాతీయ అండ్ విజాతీయ హీ సెడ్ స్వగత భేద ఈజ్ నాట్ దేర్ ఇన్ సత్ లైక్ వైజ్ సద్వస్తునః ఫార్ సంథింగ్ విచ్ ఈస్ కాల్డ్ విచ్ యూ హ్యావ్ టు కాల్ రియల్ రియల్ మీన్స్ దట్ విచ్ కెనాట్ బి నెగేటెడ్ అట్ ఎనీ పాయింట్ ఆఫ్ టైమ్ ఫర్ దట్ భేదత్రయం ప్రాప్తం నివారీయతే భేదత్రయం సో దిస్ సార్ట్ ఆఫ్ త్రీ ఫోల్డ్ డిఫరెన్సియేషన్ వన్ కెన్ సే పాస్టులేట్ భేదత్రయం ప్రాప్తం ప్రాప్తం మీన్స్ ఇట్ హెస్ నాట్ కమ్ భేదత్రయం ప్రాప్తం మీన్స్ ద క్వశ్చన్ అరైజెస్ ద క్వశ్చన్ ఆఫ్ భేదత్రయం అరైజెస్ ఈవెన్ ఇన్ ద కేస్ ఆఫ్ సత్ సో దట్ ఇస్ వాట్ ఇట్ మీన్స్ భేదత్రయం ప్రాప్తం మీన్స్ సంబడి మే పాస్టులేట్ సంబడి మే పాజిట్ సంబడి మే ప్రపోజ్ దట్ ఎస్ దెర్ ఈస్ భేదత్రయం ఇన్ దిస్ సో దట్ ఈస్ బీయింగ్ నివారీయతే దట్ ఈస్ బీయింగ్ అవాయిడెడ్ బై దిస్ స్ట్రిక్ట్ దట్ ఈస్ బీయింగ్ రిజెక్టెడ్ బై దిస్ స్క్రిప్చరల్ స్టేట్మెంట్ ఐక్య ఐక్య మీన్స్ వన్నెస్ దట్ ఈస్ ఐక్యావధారణ ద్వైత దట్ వీ హ్యావ్ టు స్ప్లిట్ ఇట్ ఐక్య అవధారణ ద్వైత ప్రతిషేధ ఐక్య మీన్స్ వన్నెస్ అవధారణ మీన్స్ ఓన్లీ అవధారణ అవధారణార్థం మీన్స్ ఎంఫసిస్ టు ఎంఫసిక్ ఎంఫటికల్లీ సే దట్ ఈస్ వాట్ ఈస్ అవధారణ అవధారయ యూ సే సో సో అండ్ సో ఋగ్వేదం అవధారయ యజుర్వేదం అవధారయ సో సో లిజన్ దట్ ఆల్సో ఈస్ ద మీనింగ్ దేర్ అవధారణ మీన్స్ దట్ ఈస్ సంథింగ్ ఎంఫటికల్ యు ఆర్ సేయింగ్ సంథింగ్ ఐక్య అవధారణ ద్వైత ప్రతిషేధ దట్ ఈస్ రిజెక్టింగ్ ది డ్యుయాలిటీ రిజెక్టింగ్ డ్యుయాలిటీ హౌ ఈజ్ ఇట్ డన్ ఏకం ఏవ అద్వితీయం బై సేయింగ్ ఏకం యు ఆర్ పాస్టులేటింగ్ ఐక్యం ఐక్యం మీన్స్ వన్నెస్ ఏకం ఇట్ ఈస్ ఓన్లీ వన్ దట్ ఈస్ దెర్ ఈస్ నో స్వగత భేద ఇఫ్ ఇట్ ఓన్లీ వన్ దెర్ ఇస్ నో స్వగత భేద అట్ ఆల్ దెన్ వెన్ డస్ సే నీడ్ ఫర్ సే బాడీ పార్ట్స్ అరైజ్ వెన్ యూ హ్యావ్ టు ఇంటరాక్ట్ విత్ సంబడి ఎల్స్ యూ హ్యావ్ టు ఇంటరాక్ట్ విత్ సంబడి ఎల్స్ యూ హ్యావ్ టు ఫైట్ విత్ సంబడి యూ నీడ్ హ్యాండ్స్ యూ హెవ్ టు కిక్ సంబడి యూ నీడ్ సే లెగ్స్ సో ఆల్ ద పార్ట్స్ ఆర్ నీడెడ్ ఇన్ ఆర్డర్ టు ఇంటరాక్ట్ విత్ సంథింగ్ ఎల్స్ ద పార్ట్స్ ఆర్ నాట్ నీడెడ్ వెన్ యూ ఆర్ ఓన్లీ వన్ దెర్ ఇస్ నో నీడ్ టు ఇంటరాక్ట్ విత్ ఎనీథింగ్ సో దట్ ఈస్ ఓన్లీ ఐక్యం ఐక్య అవధారణ దట్ ఈస్ ఏవ ఏకం ఏవ ఏవ మీన్స్ అగైన్ దేర్ ఇస్ నో సజాతీయ ఆల్సో ఏవ దేర్ ఏకం ఏవ సజా దేర్ ఇస్ నో సజాతీయం ఆల్సో దెన్ అగైన్ ఇట్ ఈస్ అగైన్ సేయింగ్ అద్వితీయం ద్వైత ప్రతిషేధ దట్ ఈస్ నాన్ డ్యూవల్ దెర్ ఈస్ అబ్సల్యూట్లీ నథింగ్ ఎల్స్ దెర్ ఇస్ నో విజాతీయ ఆల్సో నాట్ ఓన్లీ సజాతీయ దెర్ ఇస్ నో విజాతీయ ఆల్సో సో ఐక్య అవధారణ ద్వైత ప్రతిషేధై తృతీయ విభక్తి బహువచనం ద్వైత ప్రతిషేధై త్రిభిః బై దీస్ త్రీ వర్డ్స్ క్రమాత్ మీన్స్ ఇన్ ద సేమ్ ఆర్డర్ దీస్ త్రీ భేదాస్ ఆర్ రిజెక్టెడ్ వాట్ ఆర్ ది త్రీ భేదాస్ స్వగత భేద సజాతీయ భేద విజాతీయ భేద దీస్ త్రీ ఆర్ రిజెక్టెడ్ ఇన్ ద సేమ్ ఆర్డర్ బై ఏకం ఏవ అద్వితీయం ఏకం ఈజ్ రిజెక్టింగ్ స్వగత భేద ఏవ ఈజ్ రిజెక్టింగ్ సజాతీయ భేద అద్వితీయం ఈజ్ రిజెక్టింగ్ విజాతీయ భేద దట్ ఈస్ డిఫరెన్సియేషన్ విత్ రెస్పెక్ట్ టు ఎనీ అదర్ క్లాస్ దెన్ ఈజ్ ఇట్ క్లియర్ విల్ సీ ది కామెంట్ ఏకమేవ అద్వితీయమితి ఏవం అనాత్మని భేదత్రయం ప్రదర్శ్య అనాత్మని ఇన్ సంథింగ్ విచ్ ఈస్ నాన్ ఆత్మ భేదత్రయం ప్రదర్శ్య ఇన్ సంథింగ్ విచ్ ఈస్ నాన్ ఆత్మ ఇన్ సంథింగ్ విచ్ ఈస్ నాన్ సత్ సో ఇన్ ఆల్ దోస్ థింగ్స్ యూ కెన్ హ్యావ్ భేదత్రయం ఇన్ వాట్ ఈస్ వాట్ ఈస్ కాల్డ్ అనాత్మ యూ కెన్ హ్యావ్ భేదత్రయం బట్ హియర్ సద్వస్తునపి ప్రసక్తం తత్ ప్రసక్తం మీన్స్ వన్ మే పాజిట్ ఇట్ వన్ మే పాస్టులేట్ వన్ మే రైజ్ దట్ క్వశ్చన్ ప్రసక్తం ప్రసక్తి మీన్స్ దట్ కాంటెక్స్ట్ కమ్స్ ద కాంటెక్స్ట్ అరైజెస్ సో ప్రసక్తం తత్ భేదత్రయం శృతౌ ఇన్ ద శృతి పదత్రయేణ నివార్యతే ఇత్యాహ పదత్రయేణ బై త్రీ వర్డ్స్ ఇట్ ఈస్ బీయింగ్ రిజెక్టెడ్ వాట్ ఈస్ దట్ తథేతి దెన్ వస్తుత్వ సామాన్యాత్ అనాత్మని ఇవ సద్రూప ఆత్మన్యపి ప్రసక్తం వస్తు సామాన్యాత్ బికాస్ సత్ ఆల్సో ఈస్ అపారెంట్లీ లుకింగ్ లైక్ వస్తు ఓన్లీ ఇట్ ఈస్ లుకింగ్ లైక్ ఎనీ అదర్ ఆబ్జెక్ట్ సో ఇఫ్ దట్ ఈస్ సో అనాత్మని ఇవ యాజ్ ఇన్ ద కేస్ ఆఫ్ అనాత్మ సద్రూప ఆత్మని అపి ప్రసక్తం ఇన్ ఆత్మ ఆల్సో దట్ క్వశ్చన్ అరైజెస్ ప్రసక్తం స్వగతాది భేదత్రయం, స్వగత ఆది భేదత్రయం, స్వగత సజాతీయ విజాతీయ, దీస్ త్రీ టైప్స్ ఆఫ్ భేద, ఐక్య అవధారణ ద్వైత ప్రతిషేధాభిధాయకై ఏకం ఏవ అద్వితీయమితి త్రిభిః పదై, బై దీస్ త్రీ వర్డ్స్ క్రమేణ ఇన్ ద సేమ్ ఆర్డర్ నివార్యతే ఇత్యర్థః. దెన్ అగైన్ హీ సేయింగ్ ద నెక్స్ట్ శ్లోక్ ఆల్సో హీ సేయింగ్ సతో నావయవాశంక్యాస్తదంశ స్యానిరూపణాత్ నామరూపే నతస్య నతస్యాంశౌ. దేర్ ఇస్ ఎ ప్రింట్ మిస్టేక్ హియర్. నామరూపేణ అవర్ బుక్ సేస్, యూ హ్యావ్ కరెక్ట్ ఇట్ యాజ్ నామరూపే స్పేస్ న, నామరూపేణ ఇట్స్ నాట్ నామరూపేణ, నామరూపే స్పేస్ న తస్యాంశౌ, న తస్యాంశౌ తయోరద్యాప్యనుద్భవాత్. దేర్ ఇస్ ఎ పాఠాంతరం ఫర్ దట్. ఇన్స్టెడ్ ఆఫ్ తయోర్ అద్యాప్యనుద్భవాత్, ఇది పాఠాంతరం సేస్ తయోర్ ఆదావ్ అనుద్భవాత్, తయోహ ఆదౌ అనుద్భవాత్. సో విల్ సీ ది శ్లోక. సతః సతః న అవయవాః శంక్యాః, అప్ టు దట్ పాయింట్ ఇస్ వన్ లైన్. సతో నవయవాః శంక్యాః, దట్ ఈస్ అప్ టు దట్ వన్ లైన్. తద్ అంశస్య అనిరూపణాత్, తద్ అంశస్య అనిరూపణాత్, అనిరూపణాత్. దెన్ నామరూపే, నామ అండ్ రూప, న తస్య అంశౌ, న తస్య అంశౌ మీన్స్ దే ఆర్ నాట్ పార్ట్స్ ఆఫ్ దే ఆర్ నాట్ ద పార్ట్స్, అంశ ఈజ్ పార్ట్, న తస్య అంశౌ తయో అద్యాపి అనుద్భవాత్, అద్యాపి మీన్స్ ఈవన్ నౌ, అనుద్భవాత్, అనుద్భవ మీన్స్ దే ఆర్ నాట్ ఇట్ అరైజన్, దే హ్యావ్ నాట్ ఇట్ మేనిఫెస్టెడ్, అనుద్భవ మీన్స్ నాట్ మేనిఫెస్టెడ్. విల్ సీ ది శ్లోక. సతః ఫర్ దిస్ సత్, వట్ వీఆర్ కాలింగ్ ఇట్ ఎస్ సత్, నా అవయవాహ శంక్యాహ, అవయవాహ పార్ట్స్ కెనాట్ బి పాస్టులేటెడ్, నా శంక్యాహ మీన్స్ దే కెనాట్ బి సస్పెక్టెడ్, శంక మీన్స్ సస్పిషన్, ఇదంట శంక మీన్స్ ఎ డౌట్, దే షుడ్ నాట్ బి డౌటెడ్ మీన్స్ దే షుడ్ నాట్ బి డౌటెడ్ డస్ నాట్ మీన్ దే ఆర్ ఆల్వేస్ దే ఆర్ రెడీలీ దేర్, నాట్ లైక్ దాట్. దే షుడ్ నాట్ దట్ క్వశ్చన్ షుడ్ నాట్ అరైజ్. సో దట్ ఇస్ వాట్ ఇట్ ఇట్ మీన్స్ నా అవయవా శంక్యా, దే షుడ్ నాట్ బి పాస్టులేటెడ్. తదంశస్య, తదంశస్య అనిరూపణాత్, అంశ దట్ సత్ ఈజ్ హ్యావింగ్ సర్టన్ పార్ట్స్, అంశాంశి భావ విసే, అంశ అండ్ అంశి, అంశ మీన్స్ పార్ట్ అండ్ అంశి ఈజ్ దట్ విచ్ ఈజ్ హ్యావింగ్ అంశ, అవయవ అవయవి విసే, అవయవ మీన్స్ ఎ పార్ట్, అవయవి ఈజ్ దట్ విచ్ ఈజ్ హ్యావింగ్ పార్ట్, అవయవ అవయవి భావ ఆర్ అంశ అంశ అంశి భావ ఈజ్ నో వేర్ మెన్షన్డ్ ఇన్ ది శృతి అండ్ ఇట్ కెనాట్ బి పాస్టులేటెడ్ ఆల్సో లీగల్ లాజికలీ ఆల్సో లాజికలీ ఆల్సో ఇట్ కెనాట్ బి పాస్టులేటెడ్ బికాస్ సత్ కెనాట్ బి టూ, సో ఇట్ కెనాట్ బి హ్యావ్, ఇట్ కెనాట్ హ్యావ్ పార్ట్స్, పార్ట్స్ ఆర్ పార్ట్స్ కమింగ్ టు పిక్చర్ ఓన్లీ వెన్ ఇట్ హ్యాస్ టు ఇంటరాక్ట్ విత్ సంథింగ్ ఎల్స్, వెన్ దెర్ ఇస్ నో క్వశ్చన్ ఆఫ్ ఇంటరాక్షన్, వెన్ ఇట్ ఈస్ ఓన్లీ వన్ దెర్ ఇస్ నో క్వశ్చన్ ఆఫ్ ఎనీ పార్ట్స్. దెన్ నామరూపే నా తస్యాంశౌ, అప్ టు దట్ పాయింట్ వీ కెన్ సే వన్ లైన్, నామరూపే ది నేమ్ అండ్ ఫామ్ దే ఆర్ నాట్ తస్య అంశౌ, దే ఆర్ నాట్ ది అంశ. వై తయో అద్యాపి అనుద్భవాత్, అద్యాపి మీన్స్ ఈవన్ నౌ, అద్య మీన్స్ యాక్చువల్లీ మీన్స్ ఈవన్ నౌ ఇజ్ ఇట్, అనుద్భవాత్ మీన్స్ ఈవన్ నౌ మీన్స్ వాట్ డస్ హీ, వాట్ ఈస్ హీ మీనింగ్, హీ ఈజ్ మీనింగ్ విత్ రెఫరెన్స్ టు సృష్టి, బిఫోర్ సృష్టి హీ ఈజ్ రెఫరింగ్ టు, బిఫోర్ సృష్టి నామరూప హ్యావ్ నాట్ ఇట్ అరైజన్, ఓన్లీ ఆఫ్టర్ సృష్టి నామరూప హ్యాస్ అరైజన్, నామ అండ్ రూప హ్యావ్ అరైజన్, బిఫోర్ సృష్టి నామరూప హ్యాస్ నాట్ హ్యావ్ నాట్ అరైజన్. సో దిస్ సత్, వాట్ వీఆర్ కాలింగ్ ఎస్ సత్ కెనాట్ బి పాస్టులేటెడ్ ఎస్ సంథింగ్ విచ్ ఈస్ హ్యావింగ్ పార్ట్స్, ఇస్ ఇట్ క్లియర్? నామరు సత సతః నా అవయవా శంక్యాః. దెన్ హియర్ ది కామెంటరీ సేస్ సద్వస్తునః తావత్ న స్వగత భేదః శంకితుం శక్యతే, స్వగత భేదః ఈజ్ రిజెక్టింగ్ ది స్వగత భేద ఇన్ ది శ్లోక, అస్య నిరవయవత్వాత్ ఇత్యాహ, నిరవయవత్వాత్ సత్ ఈజ్ నాట్ సంథింగ్ విచ్ ఇస్ అవయవి, నామరూపయోః సదవత్వం కిం న స్యాద్ ఇతి అశంక్య, సృష్టే పురా తయోః అభావాత్, తయోః అభావాత్ బిఫోర్ సృష్టి దే వర్ నాట్ దేర్, ఇట్ నామరూప ది మేనిఫెస్టేషన్ ఆఫ్ నేమ్ అండ్ ఫామ్ అలోన్ ఈస్ సృష్టి, ఇదంట మేనిఫెస్టేషన్ ఆఫ్ దిస్ నేమ్ అండ్ ఫామ్ ఇన్ దట్ వస్తువు కాల్డ్ సత్ ఈజ్ వాట్ ఈస్ కాల్డ్ సృష్టి. సో ఫస్ట్ ఆఫ్ ఆల్ వీ హ్యావ్ టు అండర్స్టాండ్ ఎగ్జాక్ట్లీ వాట్ ఎగ్జాక్ట్లీ దిస్ సత్, సో ఐ జస్ట్ నోటెడ్ ఎ కపుల్ ఆఫ్ పాయింట్స్ బికాస్ యు నో షార్ట్ హ్యాండ్, ఇఫ్ యూ వాంట్ టు నోట్ డౌన్ యూ కెన్ నోట్ డౌన్. సో సత్ ఈజ్ సంథింగ్ యు సీ, యూజువలీ వీ ఫీల్ దట్ ది యూనివర్స్ ఈజ్ సంథింగ్ విచ్ ఈస్ రైట్ ఇన్ ఫ్రంట్ ఆఫ్ అస్ అండ్ ఇట్ ఈస్ వెరీ వెరీ డిఫికల్ట్ టు రిజెక్ట్ ది యూనివర్స్ బికాస్ ది యూనివర్స్ ఈజ్ సంథింగ్ ఐ విల్ టెల్ స్లోలీ అగైన్. universe is something which is right in front of us, and it is very, very difficult for us to reject the universe because it is appearing so real. So the universe, it cannot be, then how should it be taken as with respect to Brahma or with respect to that Sat, with respect to that existence, that supreme reality or the pure being? For that Sat, the English translation can be existence is one, reality is another word, being is another word. For this word Sat, different people translate in a different way. There is somewhere you find the translation as being, somewhere you see the translation as reality, somewhere you see it as existence, pure existence, all are one and the same. So here, why do you say that this is not that pure Sat? Because when you say that this is pure Sat, then we have to presume that there is something called, there is some sort of huge matter, the huge matter somewhere, and that huge matter is transforming into so many of these things, like so many galaxies, so many, all these Milky Way galaxies and stars, planets and earth, water, etc., etc., it has to transform itself, isn't it? So that cannot be so, because if that is so, if you feel that, if we postulate that all this thing is something which is there, body parts of that huge what is called Sat, suppose there is somebody called Brahma, a huge one which whom you can't imagine, and all this thing is body parts, then however huge that body parts may be, it is something which is still cognized by the mind, it is still something which is known by the mind, and whatever is known by the mind is something which is inferior to the mind. It becomes a subject, it becomes an object, it is something which is objectified, and you are the knower, and the knower is always superior to the known, isn't it? It is always superior to the knower, or jnanam is something which is always superior to that. So however huge it may be, it cannot be the bodily parts of Brahman. So what else is it? So obviously you have to say something else. It is not exactly the body part, it is something which is a manifestation. So that is how we have to understand it. It is very, very difficult to realize. We may say logically, but it is very difficult to realize. So another point is, so first point we can note is, the universe, it cannot be the bodily parts of this, of this Sat or Brahma, because if Brahma were to be an avayavi, then Brahma will become delimited. If Brahma were to be an avayavi, Brahma would be delimited. And Brahma is infinite. Brahma has to be infinite according to the definition, where it has to be infinite, otherwise he will be a limited person, he will no longer be the highest. So only niravayavi can be, say that, infinite. So that is one point. Then again, names and forms, as we see, just now in another way of saying is, all the names and forms, suppose there is a galaxy, there is a star, there is this, that, etc., etc., all these are names and forms, isn't it? All these names and forms are knowable by the mind. Another way of saying is, all these things are knowable by the mind. And anything is knowable. The same thing as I said. So Brahman cannot be limited. So this is the point. And so names and forms must be an appearance in that reality, or what we can call the substratum behind what we are seeing. Whatever we see, there has to be some substratum behind what is being, on which all this is appearing. And the famous example is that of a rope snake. There is a rope on which you are seeing a snake, and then you are afraid and what not. So there is a very common example. So then another reason is, Sat has to be beyond the cause-effect relationship, causal cause-effect relationship, Sat, whatever we call Sat. Why is this said? Suppose somebody says, no, in Brahma only, from Brahma only, some little part of Brahma is taken out, and then his whole universe has been carved out. We are saying Brahma is the cause for this universe. That again is something which is a tentative postulation only, and it is not an absolute postulation. That Brahma is the cause for this universe is only a tentative postulation. It is not an absolute postulation. Because we have to say that yes, there is something. That is how we are saying. So, Brahma, this what we call this Sat, pure Sat or pure being, has to be beyond this Karya Karana Sambandha. This we have seen in Taittiriya Upanishad also. Satyam Jnanam Anantam Brahma, in that elaboration also, Shankaracharya was saying that Sat has to be beyond this Karya and Karana. Because if it is not beyond this karya karana sambandha, it will become jada. If what we call being is the cause for the universe which is being seen, so what exactly is the process by which this universe is formed? Is it by transformation? Parinama, what we call parinama, just a transformation. If it is transformation, like milk becoming curd, so then obviously that also becomes a vastu. It becomes a jada. When it becomes vastu, when it becomes something which is an object, it becomes jada only. So jadatva nivarana, you have to reject that jadatva in that Brahma. So for these reasons, sat is something which is beyond the karya karana sambandha. Sat is something which is the substratum of what all is appearing. And this jagat which we are seeing cannot be the body parts of that Brahma. Because if it were to be body parts of that Brahma, then you are superior to that Brahma, because you are the knower, you are seeing it. Whereas you yourself is something which is a derivative of all these five elements which is there. So that is how we have to understand this sat. Anyway, so sato navayava shankya. So next shloka we'll see. Namarupodbhavasyaiva srushtitvat srushtitah pura natayorudbhavastasman niramsham sad yathaviyat. Same thing he is telling in a different way. Namarupa udbhavasya eva srushtitvat srushtitah pura natayoh udbhavah. Srushtitah pura natayoh udbhavah. Up to that point is one line. Tasmat niramsham sat, kama yatha viyat. So the meaning is, namarupodbhavasyaiva srushtitvat. That is, what is srushti? Srushti is namarupasya udbhavah only. Namarupasya udbhavah is srushti. Tadeva saeva srushtihi. Namarupodbhavah eva srushtihi. That means, the emergence or the manifestation or the name of the name and form, that only is srushti. Otherwise there is no, how do you define srushti? This emergence of all these things is only srushti. So then srushtita, if that is srushti, then srushtitaha pura. Srushtitaha pura means before srushti. Srushtitaha is panchami. Srushtitaha pura na tayoha udbhava. And before srushti they were not there. Namarupodbhava, the emergence of name and form alone is srushti, and that means that before srushti means they were not there. Then tasmat niramsham sat, hence that sat, what we call sat, or the pure being, or the pure existence, or pure reality, is something which is beyond this karya karana bhava. That is something which is niramsham. It is niravayavi. Niramsham is niravayavi. Amsham is a part, avayava. So niramsham sat yatha viyat, just as viyat. Viyat is sky, space. Viyat is space. Viyat ganga, we say viyat. Then asya niravayavatvadidya ityaha. So here commentary, nothing much in this commentary. So this tat padartham is something which is what we call sat, or tat padartham is something which is niravayavam. The basic point is that, and only whatever is sat only is manifesting. Whatever is absolute, absolute is another, it can be another translation for this word sat. Sat means being, existence, reality, or absolute reality, all these things can be used. So this absolute itself is appearing as what is called a relative. Absolute is appearing as a relative. Then this absolute reality means which is without names and forms. In the beginning it had no names and forms. So asat is, then we are coming to this word called asat also. Asat is an empirical reality. What we are calling asat is an empirical reality, or a tentative reality, or some other words like transactional reality. Then unreal also we are saying, relative, phenomenal. All these translations are synonymous. Phenomenal we say, this phenomenal universe. Transactional reality, vyavaharika satta, in Sanskrit we say vyavaharika satta. So all they are synonymous. So natayor udbhavah tasmat niramsham sat yatha viyat. So the commentary also there is nothing much. Then we come to the next shloka. Is this shloka clear? Then next shloka is rejecting what is called Sajatiya Bheda. So he first said what exactly is the threefold differentiation. Then in the first shloka he rejected Swagata Bheda. Now in this shloka he is rejecting Sajatiya Bheda. Sadantaram Sajatiyam na Vailakshanya Varjanat Namarupopadhi Bhedam Vina Naiva Satobhida. This is also, shloka is simple, but only thing is we have to take it, taking it to the mind only is problem. Shloka apparently is simple. Sadantaram. Sadantaram means Vastvantaram. Another Vastu. Like we say Vastvantaram, Gramantaram, Deshantaram. Deshantaram is another country. Gramantaram is another village. Vastvantaram is another Vastu. Sadantaram is another Sat. Sadantaram Sajatiyam. Sajatiyam is of the same class. Na. It doesn't exist. It cannot exist because once we say that this is also Sat and that is also Sat, then both becomes limited. When there are two sats, there are two things which we are calling this is also sat and this is also sat, then obviously they become limited, they become delimited. And whatever is delimited is not Brahma, that is not the pure being. So, sadantaram sajatiyam na. Why? Vailakshanya varjanat. Because you don't see any type of difference. Vailakshanyam, vailakshanyam is different characteristics. We know what is called lakshanam. Lakshanam is a characteristic. Lakshanam is a characteristic. What are the lakshanam? Lakshanani we say. Lakshanam is a characteristic. Vailakshanyam is having different characteristics. The quality of being, the quality of having different characteristics. That is what is called Vailakshanyam. Vilakshana is something distinct, isn't it? Vilakshanasya bhavaha Vailakshanyam. Lakshanam. Vilakshana, Vilakshana, this is something which is Vilakshanam. Vilakshanam is something which is distinct. Vailakshanyam is Vilakshanasya Bhavaha is Vailakshanyam. That is having that differentiation. So, Vailakshanya Varjanat, because you do not see any type of different features. So, if you look at a man, one man is different from another man. One person is thin, another person is stout, one is small, one is big, one is... So you find so many differentiating or rather distinguishing features between two people or two different things. But in the case of Sat, there cannot be two things. Because again, if there are two things, it becomes limited. Sadantaram sajatiyam na vailakshanya varjanat. Because there is absolutely no vailakshanya. Vailakshanya means difference. There is no bhedam. Then nama rupa upadhi bhedam vina naiva sato vida. Apart from bhedam vina means apart from this differentiation due to name and form. Nama rupa upadhi bhedam vina. Nama and rupa are just upadhis. So this word newly is coming, upadhi. Upadhi means just it is having a tentative appearance. So upadhi is something which is having just a tentative appearance. And it is making it appear as though it is a distinct thing. It is having some tentative appearance, tentative reality. And it is making it appear as though it is something distinct. So that is what is Namarupa Upadhi Veda. Upadhi, we have come across that word several times, right from the beginning. Upadhi, you take that crystal, near the crystal you keep, a red rose. The crystal is appearing red. So it is that red rose is the sort of upadhi, which is upadhi dharma is appearing in this particular thing, in this crystal. So like that, namarupa upadhi bhedam vena. Namarupas, they are the tentative reality which are making it appear as though there is some sort of differentiation. So upadhi bhedam vena, naiva, naiva is never, na eva, never, sato bhida, sataha, bhida, bhida means differentiation. Naiva, in that sat, there cannot be any type of differentiation. Then, the commentary is, Mabhut Sagata Bhedaha. Okay, we agree there may be. Mabhut means, okay, we agree, Mabhut, and that there not be Swagata Bheda. That means, okay, we agree that there is no Swagata Bheda. What about Sajatiya Bheda? Sajatiya Bheda kim nasyat? Why not Sajatiya Bheda? Iti ashankya. Sadantaram iti vaktavyam. Then tan nirupayitum shakyate tato vailakshanya bhavad ityaha. Nanu ghatasatta patasatte iti sato bhedaha pratibhasate iti ashankya. Now in the world we come across so many objects, ghata, pata, so many things. Ghata means a pot, pata means a cloth. Ghata is, there is a what is called ghataness or partness. Clothness is also there. So clothness is the lakshanam of cloth. Partness is the say quality, or that is the definition for part. So you are seeing so many things. Why not in sat? So patasatte iti sato bheda pratibhasate iti ashankya ghata akasha mata akasha vad aupadhiko bheda na svato bhati ityarthah. So this differentiation is like ghata akasha mata akasha. These two are upadhis only. This ghata, existence of ghata, this ghata is so-called ghata is an, it is an upadhi. The so-called cloth is an upadhi. It is an upadhi which is making it, it is something similar to a pot space or a room space. Pot space is ghata akasha. In this huge space, there is no differentiation. Suppose I take one, say cup, and in this cup also there is space. And this space is called cup space. Technically it is ghata akasha. This is also ghata. Ghata is an object. And in this room, there is what is called space, isn't it? So this is called matha akasha. So this is actually serving as a sort of upadhi, a sort of delimiting factor, delimiting adjunct, as we say, delimiting adjunct or delimiting factor. So similarly, the room also is acting as a sort of delimiting factor or delimiting agent. So upadhi bhedam vina, just like ghata akasha and matha akasha, the bhedam is only like that. Bhedam is only relating to upadhi and not in reality. Nama rupa upadhi bhedam vina. Aupadhiko bhedaha na svataha bhati. It is not there in reality. Na svataha bhati, not in reality. Then sadvastu sajatiya bhedarahitam bhavitum arhati upadhi paramarsha mantarena vibhavyamana avibhavyamana bhedatvat. Sat is something, this line is, he is doing some anumana prayogam. If you want to read this line, sadvastu sajatiya bhedarahitam bhavitum arhati, that is the statement. Whatever we call sat is something which is beyond this sajatiya bheda. Why? Upadhi paramarsha mantarena. Apart from reference to upadhi, upadhi paramarsha, paramarsha means reference to upadhi, antarena means without that, avibhavyamana bhedatvat, the bhedam cannot be conceived, bhedam cannot be visualized, except with reference to upadhi, you cannot conceive of any difference. When upadhi is not there, there is no difference, so that is what it is. Then here commentary, of course, there is nothing. Then we come to the next shloka. Then now we are talking about vijatiya bheda. What is this? Svagata bheda he rejected, sajatiya bheda he rejected, now vijatiya bheda. And for sat, what can be a vijatiya? When you say sat, existence, then what can be the vijatiya? Non-existence, isn't it? Non-existence means? Not seen at all. So for something which is existent, how can that something which is not seen at all, how can this be a counter? How can that be a counter or pratiyogi or a rival? He is using a technical term called pratiyogi. Pratiyogi is a term which comes in Nyaya Shastra, that is this Nyaya, that is Tarka Shastra. Usually it is translated as counter positive. Pratiyogi, it is treated as counter positive. Darkness is the counter positive to light. Pratiyogi, so something like that. So this, but here counter positive is actually a slightly difficult word. You can call it a rival. Simple, ordinary English, it can be called a rival. Pratiyogi. So how can something which is totally non-existent be a rival, be a counter positive to something which is sat? That is what he is saying in this. Vijatiyam asat tattu na kalvasti iti gamyate nasyatah pratiyogitvam vijatiyad bhidakutaha. Vijatiyam asat, up to that point is one line. Vijatiyam asat, that is, for sat, what is the vijatiyam? For sat, for something which is existing, what is the opposite of existing? Non-existence. So vijatiyam, that is something belonging to the other class, differentiation with respect to other class. So with respect to sat, vijatiyam is something which is asat, non-existence. Non-existence is the rival for existence. then tattu, but strictly speaking, it is not there. Na khalvasti iti gamyate, tattu, na khalvasti, it is not there, iti gamyate, it is known as, oh, it doesn't exist. It is na gamy, it is gamyate means it is known as. It is known as what? Na khalvasti, it is not there, iti gamyate. So something which is not there, how can it be a sort of rival to this? So that is what he says. Na asya ataha pratyogitvam. Na asya ataha pratyogitvam. Ataha. Ataha means therefore. Asya. Asya means for this sat. For this sat padartha. Na tasya pratyogitvam. Na asya ataha pratyogitvam. That is ataha. There are three words there. Na asya ataha pratyogitvam. Na asya ataha. Has to be split as na asya ataha. Ataha therefore. Asya. Asya means for that asat, not sat, for that asat, na pratyogitvam, pratyogitvam na bhavati. Asat, asat vastunah, for this asat, asat cannot be the pratyogi for something which is sat. Sanskrit is slightly complicated here. Nasyata pratyogitvam. Did you understand it? Ataha therefore, asya, asya means for this asat, asya is shashti vibhakti. For this asat, pratyogitvam na bhavati. That is, it doesn't qualify to be the pratyogi. Pratyogitvam na bhavati means it doesn't qualify to be the pratyogi, it doesn't qualify to be the rival, it doesn't qualify to be the counter positive for this sat. Nasyata pratyogitvam. Then, up to that point is one line. The next line is vijatiyat bhida kutaha. For something which is vijati, vijatiyat. When there is no vijatiya padartha at all, then where is the question of fear? Where is the question of challenge? Bhida means there is no question of bheda, there is no question of differentiation. Of course, not bhaya, bhida means differentiation. Where is the question of differentiation when vijatiya vastu itself is not there? So the commentary also is very, very one line. Sataha vijatiyam asat. The line is sataha vijatiyam asat. The vijatiyam for sat is asat. Then tasya asatvenaiva pratyogitva asambhavena. Asatvenaiva pratyogitva asambhavena. Because it is asat, it cannot be a pratyogi. Because it is something which is unreal, it cannot be a pratyogi. Asambhavena tat pratyogikopi bhedaha nasti. That is what he says. It cannot be pratyogi because it is asat. That snake, for example, snake in a rope. Example, suppose you take in a snake in a rope. Snake in a rope, it is not vijatiya. Because, or kapushpa. Kapushpa is something which is a flower in the sky. It cannot be vijatiya. Because it is something which is totally asat. So it cannot be a pratyogi for something which is real. Then, now he says, conclusion. Ekameva dvitiyam sat siddham atra tu kechana vihvala asadevedam purasi dityavarnayan. Ekameva dvitiyam sat siddham. Ekam eva dvitiyam sat siddham. Up to that point is one line. Sat it siddham. Atra tu kechana vihvalaha asad eva idam pura asit. Asad eva idam pura asit. Iti avarnayan. So the meaning of this is siddham. Siddham means it is proved. What is proved? Ekam eva advitiyam sat. That is what is proved. That is, the sat is something which is ekam eva advitiyam. That is, sat is something which is, that being is something which is one, only, without rival, that non-dual. So this thing, what is proved? Then atra, but in this context, atra tu, kechana. Atra tu is on the other hand. So, kechana, some people. And to whom is he referring? He is referring to this, what is called Shunyavadi. Shunyavadi or Madhyamika. Madhyamika is one branch of Buddhism. One branch, Buddha, you know, Buddha, he lived in 6th century BC. BC means BCE as we call it. BC and AD are the terms to be avoided, it seems. AD, it is a pure Christian terminology, Anno Domini, Year of the Lord. So even the Westerners, they are not using the word AD now. They are saying it CE, Common Era. For BC, they are saying BCE, before Common Era. So he belonged to 6th century BCE, who Buddha. And he lived for a long time. He lived a long life, that is about 80 years of life, and he did not write anything. And he was moving about. He did not stay in an ashrama, he did not establish a peetam, he did not have a particular peetam. He moved all around, and he gave talks in different places. So people in different places, they heard him at various points of time. Maybe in Buddha's thought itself, there could have been some change. Or the people who understood Buddha in so many places, they understood his teachings in a slightly different way. Same teacher saying something here, and suppose depending on the eligibility of the other person, depending on the comprehension of the other person. Suppose somebody comes and asks about the God, is there God existing? Somebody Buddha says, okay, Buddha is silent at that point of time. There was some question about Sapt or something. Suppose Buddha is silent on that. And he only says, you do good, be good, etc., overcome suffering, be compassionate. Buddhism in the beginning, it was more about ethics and social philosophy than metaphysics and all these serious questions of ontology and all that. So Buddha, we are not very sure, nobody is sure. If you read the history of philosophy, nobody is sure about what exactly Buddha said. But after Buddha's death, a few months after Buddha's death, it seems there was a Buddhist council, first Buddhist council, where they tried to codify certain things. Then after about a century or two centuries, there was another Buddhist council in which they consolidated the supposed teachings of Buddha into three baskets. They were called the three pitaka. Pitaka means a basket, three pitaka. So they were put into three pitakas. One is called a sutta pitaka. Sutta means whatever sayings which Buddha said, sutras which he said. Vinaya pitaka. Vinaya pitaka mostly relating to ethics and all that. Then another pitaka called Abhidhamma pitaka. Abhidhamma pitaka is about metaphysics. So there were three different things. Two almost related to social life, ethics, etc. One is relating to metaphysics. So that was the second Buddhist council. The third Buddhist council took place much, much later. So that is supposed to be, all this is supposed to be the Pali canon. If we see the Buddhist history, Pali canon. Canon means a canonical text, as we say. Canonical text means a text which is a standard for a particular, religion or creed or some ism. So Pali canon is that all these things, Tripitaka, etc. But later Buddhism is called Mahayana Buddhism. The original thing was called Hinayana Buddhism. The Hinayana does not mean inferior. Hina, only thing is these people called themselves Mahayana, high vehicle. And they called the other one as Hinayana. And this, when it comes to Mahayana Buddhism, this Mahayana Buddhism is also called Shunyavada, etc. That is by 1st century CE, Common Era. First century Common Era, even prior to that, probably some changes in Buddhist thought must have come in. So Nagarjuna, who is supposed to be one of the chief proponents of Mahayana Buddhism, what is called Shunyavada or Madhyamika, whom we are rejecting now. Madhyamika is now being rejected. So this Madhyamika philosophy is something which came slightly a few centuries after Buddha. And by the time, by the time of Christ, it was always already in existence, it looks like that. So this Madhyamika is otherwise called Shunyavada. And Nagarjuna, he is supposed to be the proponent of the Shunyavada. And he is a very prolific writer, he has written several books. And Madhyamika Karika is almost similar to our Gaudapada Karika. Gaudapada Karika, we are aware. We are also having a reference to Gaudacharya here. So Gaudapada Karika is a Karika on Mandukya Upanishad. There is a very elaborate, it is a sort of elaboration on Mandukya Upanishad, Gaudapada Karika. And Gaudapada is, he belongs to the 6th century AD. He is supposed to be the Paramaguru of Shankaracharya. Gauda, according to tradition, Shankaracharya's guru is Govinda Bhagavatpada. We see in all commentaries, Govinda Prabhu, Iti Srimad Shankara, Govinda Bhagavatpada, Pujya Pada Shishya, Srimad Shankara, Shankaracharya Kurta, etc. So Shankaracharya is the student of Govinda Bhagavatpada. Govinda Bhagavatpada was supposed to be the student of Gaudapada Acharya. Gauda is a particular land Somewhere in northern Bengal now, the present day Bengal, northern Bengal, that area is Gowda. Also very close to Nepal, where Buddha lived. If you see geographically, very, very close to where Buddha lived. So Buddha's teachings, they were all prominent there. So then Gaudapada, he told almost the same things. We are not very sure as to who borrowed from whom, whether they borrowed from Upanishads, whether it is Upanishadic thought, because Upanishads, they were much, much older. Probably Buddha also took some of the say statements from the Upanishads and then projected in his own manner. Projected means by excluding all this ritualism of these Mimamsakas. Buddha, he rejected all these rituals. Rejecting all the ritualism of the Mimamsakas, he seems to have taken the highlighted the philosophical aspects which are there in the say Upanishads. So the same thing again, some of the technical terms or terminology used by Buddhist writers, again probably they are taken by our Vedantins also. It looks like that there is some sort of intermixture. So anyway, so when we refer to Madhyamikas, we are referring to what is called Shunyavada of Nagarjuna, who lived in 2nd century Common Era, CE. So let us see. Ekameva Advitiyam Sat Siddham Atra Tu Kechana. Kechana means some people. Some people means some people say like this. When we say, what does it mean? Some people say like that, but I don't agree. So that's what it is. Kechana. That Kechana becomes the Purvapakshi. Kechana. Vihvalaha. Vihvalaha means totally confused people. Vihvala. We say Madavihvala. Madavihvala, we say Madavihvala means he is so intoxicated and then incoherent. So that is what it means. Intoxicated, Madavihvala. So like that, losing sense, they have lost their senses in that sense, in that meaning. Vihvalaha asad eva idam pura asit. All this was asat. All this was shunya. Shunya means void in that sense. All that is, all what all existed was void. Iti avarnayan. Avarnayan means they described like that. They described like that. Vihvalaha. Some people foolishly described like that. So that is what he says. Then still time is there, isn't it? Fine, fine. So, is this shloka clear? Dekameva advitiyam sat siddham. It is siddham. It is very clearly proved that one alone existed. But in this context, some confused people say that asadeva asir. Some people, confused people say that there is asat. Iti avarnayan. Then again, this 27th shloka is just a condemnation of those people. 27th shloka, just flatly condemning, these are fools who are almost like, they are like people who are drowning in a sea and then who have lost their senses. So that is what it means. Magnasyab dhavyathakshani vihvalani tathasyadhihi akhandaikarasam shrutva nishprachara bibhetyataha magnasya abdhav yatha akshani. Abdhav magnasya yatha akshani. Abdhav means in the ocean. Abdhi means ocean. Abdhav is in the ocean. Magnasya, a person who is so totally submerged. Magna, majja, nimajjanam, you know the word nimajjanam, Ganesham, nimajjanam. So magna is something, somebody who is immersed, somebody who is there, sunk, let us say, in the ocean. Abdhav magnaha, agna, magnasya, yatha, akshani. Akshani means indriyani. Aksham is indriyam. Aksham is indriyam, akshani, plural. Yatha, akshani, vihvalani. Vihvala means totally confused, baffled, he has no sense. He can't see, he can't breathe, he can't do anything. All his senses are totally baffled. Yatha, akshani, vihvalani. Tatha, asya dhihi. Asya means of that Purvapakshi. Likewise, asya dhihi, that person's brain is like that. That person's intellect is so confused. Then, how? Akhandaikarasam shrutva nishprachara vibhetyataha tasya dhihi. What happens to his buddhi? Nishprachara bhavati. Nishprachara means it cannot enter, it cannot go. Prachara means ability to go in, ability to walk in, ability to move. Nishprachara means inability to go, inability to understand, inability to attain. Inability to understand is the meaning here. Nishprachara. Inability to understand what? Akhandaikarasam. Akhandaikarasam means that sat. in which there is no differentiation. Akhanda, there is no parts, there is no differentiation in that sat. Akhanda, ekarasa. Ekarasa is that homogeneous, where absolutely there is no cause-effect relationship, there is no differentiation, there is no avayava, avayavibhava, there is nothing. Then what else are you postulating? We are going to postulate Vivartavada, which we will see later. Vivartavada is that this Jagat is a sort of manifestation in that sat only. Sat being the substratum behind what is that real. So, akhandaikarasam, that Brahma which is one alone, which has no parts, no avayava, which is beyond time and beyond cause and effect and all that shrutva, nishpracharaha, they are unable to understand it. Nishpracharaha, bibhetyataha, bibheti means they are afraid, bibheti. Bibheti, bibheti, bibheti is plural, bibheti, ataha. Bibheti is singular, bibheti, we are referring to dhihi, tasya dhihi, bibheti. Bibheti is plural, sorry. Bibheti, tasya dhihi bibheti. His dhi, his buddhi is afraid. His buddhi is afraid to comprehend the non-dual reality. Who is that? Madhyamika, that Shunyavadi's buddhi is so scared, it is unable to comprehend the reality which is non-dual. So here the commentator also is the same thing. Asya is asadvadinaha. Asadvadi is not one person, there are so many people. So why are you saying one asya jyatav ekavachanam? When you are referring to a big class, category of people, ekavachanam is good enough. You can say, the communist says like this, we say. When you say, oh, this communist is saying like that, you are referring to all the communists, so like that. Jyatav ekavachanam, dhihi antahkaranam. Dhi means antahkaranam. Akhandaikarasam vastu shrutva. Then that akhandaikarasam I explained. Nishpracharaha. Nishpracharaha means who are not able to comprehend. Sakara vastuni iva akhandaikarase vastuni prachara rahita sati. If you are able to comprehend, if it is a sakara vastu, you are able to comprehend it. Okay, sakara vastu, okay, this is so big, so long, so tall, etc., etc. You are able to mentally comprehend. But nirakara, akhandaikarasa. Akhandaikarasa, nirakara, niravayavi vastu, if it is there. In that case, prachara rahita, unable to reach it, unable to attain it, unable to comprehend it. Prachara rahita sati, ataha asmad vastuno bibheti. Vastunaha bibheti. Panchami vibhakti. When that bhi comes, panchami vibhakti comes, isn't it? Vastuno bibheti. Rushat, simhat bhayam, vyagrat bhayam, bhayaha. So, like that. Bhaya, when that bhi comes, panchami vibhakti comes. So asmad vastuno bibheti. So de pracharat bibheti. Shall we go to next shloka? Time is over. Okay. We'll continue next. Now we are seeing, we'll be getting that Gaudacharya, reference to Gaudacharya, that Gaudapadacharya. We'll see tomorrow. Harihi Om Tat Sat.